Hi, everybody. Welcome to your weekly cooking chicken call. My name is Lee Honish. It is August 18th, 9:14 a.m. Thank you, everybody that is on call live. I'll go back to your questions momentarily. This is the recorded portion of the program that goes into the archives and usually gets used as a podcast as well. I found out some extremely disturbing news this week about the market. First of all, I have said categorically that the market wasn't going to crash. I am changing that position right here, right now, as you listen to it. The market's going to crash. And I don't mean crash. I just mean prices are going to come back down, right? So we have an inflation issue. I've been talking to some bank people, watching videos, and actually getting to my roots, as they say. So I made a bunch of phone calls, and I watched a bunch of videos, and I did a bunch of homework. And there is an issue with the dollar and the inflation of the dollar and the overpricing of homes right now in general. And that is a serious issue. Jobs and what people make in those jobs, right? So dollar for dollar, job to job. Those generally dictate the value of homes. They grow and they decline at the same rate. Over the last several years, and most importantly, over the last 2 years because of COVID, prices have spiked upwards to alarming rates. So if you don't know this, last week they did a poll and 66% of millennials said they're not buying and they're waiting out the market. That's bad news. Number two, there are markets that are gaining actual listings that they have not had. Even here in San Diego, we've gained 5% more listings than what we had a year ago. So we're trending in a different direction in a lot of markets. Those are some contributing factors. But the most disturbing fact I heard on a video that I couldn't believe out of the Kwok brothers, who I respect a great deal, sounded so outlandish that it actually caused me in the middle of the night to call everyone I know. And that's what started this before I actually went on stage yesterday on Tuesday. The Kwok brothers presented the fact, anybody see The Big Short here in the room? So if you don't know anything about credit swaps were what really made 2007, 8, 9, and 10 famous, right? So there's a great, The Big Short, Connie. There's a great piece by Anthony Bourdain that I'll probably insert right here and probably get a copyright infringement, but I'll do it. So I'll take a pause right here.
A collateralized debt obligation. It's important to understand because it's what allowed a housing crisis to become a nationwide economic disaster. Here's world famous chef Anthony Bourdain to explain.
Okay, I'm a chef on a Sunday afternoon setting the menu at a big restaurant. I ordered my fish on Friday, which is the mortgage bond that Michael Burry shorted. But some of the fresh fish doesn't sell. I don't know why. Maybe it just came out. Halibut has the intelligence of a dolphin. So what am I going to do? Throw all this unsold fish, which is the BBB level of the bond, in the garbage and take the loss? No way. Being the crafty and morally onerous chef that I am, whatever crappy levels of the bond I don't sell, I throw into a seafood stew. See, it's not old fish. It's a whole new thing. And the best part is they're eating three-day-old halibut. That is a CDO.
Okay, that was Anthony Bourdain explaining credit swap. So basically, here's how it works. You package a lot of shitty loans with a few good loans and you make a whole stew out of it and then you sell it. In those days, we sold it, Connie, right? Wacky Swiss, right? Those were the buyers. Credit Suisse, who's buying it? I don't know, Crazy Suisse, right? So, and they're called tranches. This is a very cool thing in those days. They were able to just package up their shit and sell it off. So I thought Dodd-Frank, as well as everything else that was passed, would stop banks from doing it. Well, it did stop banks from doing it. They found a different way to do it. So we're not talking A-tier lenders. We're not talking U.S. Bank, Wells, Chase, or B of A. No, no, we're talking second tier. Because A-tier has actually tightened their lending lines. I just confirmed this yesterday with a very big mortgage broker who owns several mortgage companies. I'm like, grade A is kind of hard to come by, right? It's tight. Yes. And if you don't know that, that's a fact. Grade A is tight. The banks are cutting credit lines. They're all quietly doing it. They're cutting down the loans they make. but they are making 90-day loans to second-tier mortgage companies.
Right.
Just think of your favorite. They probably did the deal for your last buyer, okay? So they make 90-day loans. They lend it to these second-tier Alt-A, subprime, term sound familiar? Those people take shaky loans, package them with good loans that they make as well, and guess who they're selling to? Anybody know this? This is true. And they're buying 100% of these. Ginnie Mae. Now you're ready for the big tie-in of what I talked about a few months ago? Ginnie Mae's plan is to give them all the 40-year recast loan mod to keep them all healthy. Voila. The triangle of tranche continues from 2007. That's a problem. And here's why. What is the first thing I have taught all of you in all of my rooms about my dad? Anybody get this correct? I will do something wonderful for you. Make a webpage or something. Does anybody know the answer? What is the one thing I teach every room that my dad taught me that I teach all of you? Anyone know? People who don't pay, don't pay. Good job, Diana Ramirez. You get an hour with me. Ah, she's faster than you, Donald. People who don't pay, don't pay. I don't care if you give them a 40-year loan. I don't care if you give them a 50-year loan. You get a loan. You get a loan. You get a loan. Everyone gets a loan. Doesn't matter. People who don't pay, don't pay. So guess what? Ginnie Mae is going to be on the hook for a big pile of dog poop. The second tiers are all going to crumble because they won't be able to pay back the big grade A, and the grade A's can write it off because it wasn't at risk to begin with. I mean, it's all off the books crap. It's fantastic, fantastic that this is happening. And I could not believe it when it was presented on a video. So I made a bunch of phone calls. Bad news, good news. Good news for you guys if you want to work distressed properties. Good news if you believe that the market's completely overvalued and has to come back down to earth. Good news for you if you believe that millennials have stopped buying, or it's bad news, right? I don't know. Truly, it's devastating news. It is. Like, the market's got real issues. The dollar's overvalued. All of that stuff is in a horrible, horrible situation. The dollar is completely overvalued. Gas prices are too high. Milk is like 40 cents a gallon more than it should be. Like, everything is overvalued, right? And we just keep printing more money, which devalues the dollar further. And if you take away your quote unquote cream of the crop buyers, millennials, right? You guys are in a lot of trouble, which means days on market go up. So the question is, what market should you be looking at, which will tell you when you see prices decline? There is one market that is doing it. It is, anyone know? Boise, Idaho. They have 35% more inventory. Their prices are completely out of whack. And as soon as their prices start to slide here in the next few days, month or so, we will start to see other cities appear and the cracks start to happen. I thought it was yesterday because of the stock market slide. Not so. Kind of rebounded by the end of the day. But there's lots of things brewing. Which takes me to the last part of today's coaching call. You guys are all up to date on the market. I want to give you an update on what I'm going to be working on my vacation. Yes, I said it, on my vacation. I'm going to show you stuff I am working on. So for those of you who don't know, you are currently looking at this is the back page. This is where I go into Kajabi. And those of you who are part of the coaching program, any of them, you get the Home Advocates Marketing System, the Home Advocates Community, and the Hub. Some of you on this call are old Monster or AMS users, and you guys have your own little place in your own little private Idaho, and I rebuilt it from scratch for you, even including some of David's stuff. Now, I am talking specifically to home advocate users, people who have upgraded, people who are part of the site, a couple of people who just signed up yesterday, people who signed up this week. First of all, thank you. I'm very grateful. I am going to change this particular funnel completely, the Home Advocate Marketing System page, and I'm going to tell you why. This was the original landing point when you came into the system. I'm going to show it to you on the screen. So when you used to come into Home Advocates, this was the first thing I built. which was sort of a revised version of all of my marketing broken down. I'm going to rechange it, and it's going to be a module by module explanation of, ready for this? Of, come on, the hub. So I'm going to go through and I'm going to explain each module in the hub and how to use it. So I don't think you need an 8-hub module to explain how to do the 12-step program, right? So if you don't know, the 12-step program is our direct marketing method. And it's also a funny Bill W. joke for those of out there that are Bill W. people. And so I made 13 steps. Again, funny Bill W. joke, tap 13 steps, and very Lee. All of these are how to set up and run our marketing system. And I can tell you definitively right now, watch this. These are leads that I'm showing you on the screen. There's a lead. There's a lead. There's a lead. There's a, oh, sorry. There's a lead. There's a lead. There's a lead. System works. Okay. You just got to go put up the marketing pieces. So this system actually works. I am going to systematically go through everything and redo all of this into explanations of each one of these, right? So the 12-step program is the direct marketing method. The face-to-face marketing method, which is why you guys are on the front page of the website. Again, I'll record this. If you want your DRE number on the front page, please send it, okay? I plan to list you guys on the front page. I don't know any efficient way for you to like input information that it goes directly onto the website. So it's being done manually each week by me. I'm doing my best. So we'll see how that goes. Maybe I'll think of a better system, but for now I have to manually input them. If you feel that you need to be in compliant, include your DRE number, or you don't want to be listed on the front page, please let me know. But this is for the basic referral marketing system, right? The business card is here. I believe it was Gilbert who sent me a copy of his card that he ordered. Congratulations. I dug it. Our coaching calls are all up to date. The Express Buyer Program is in play. We actually have a couple of files running in it right now. The Investor Portal for all you investors. I've got one of those and it has been submitted. I'm waiting on a CMA or a comp on that one. Of course, the archives and all the video archives, as well as some white label books that you can claim as an author. Now, more importantly, I'm going to add on here, right here, probably the next module, is going to be appointment number 2 through infinity, right? So I'm going to list probably the top 10 documents that you will probably need to take back, including some updated materials as well. I'm also going to work on a brand new module. Of course, I'm just adding all these. I don't need to. The system is absolutely worth every penny of what we ask you to invest at this moment. But I'm going to add the video funnel with a generic video of me, right? And how to set that up. So I will do a generic, hey, this person, I'm a home advocate. And the person who put this, they're a home advocate too. Check the line out above and they want to help you type video. It'll be professional. I'll probably wear a tie and a suit when I shoot it. But my next two funnels are that. I think you guys need an appointment 2 through infinity, right? Where you can go down and create the perfect little package, right? And I think you also need a video funnel package where you can download me and put that on your social media and use that with the methods that I've taught you guys. And those are the next set of upgrades that I'm working on, as well as turning the original Home Advocates marketing system. Each module will just be an explanation of each module. I don't think I need, this is a very in-depth, slow burn explanation of how to put it all together. Everything now is on the hub, right? So if you guys need links for coaching calls, you just go to the coaching call page and all the links are right here. They're available. I put them all in one spot. You can't lose them. Just log in and you're right there. That's everything. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, I'm actually running the company this week, 833-969-4673. or send me an email, lee@honish.io. We did raise our prices back up. I don't know, because Derek's on an airplane. If you were thinking about upgrading or investing at the old price, send me an email. Maybe I can work a deal. lee@honish.io. Now I've got Derek all fired up because I explained tranches, and he's like, we need to raise the price. I said, that's my line, which I thought was hilarious. But there you guys go. You're all caught up now. And I will take questions from the people that are here.